special self. Just welcome everybody to the banquet. We're so glad they're here. And have come from far and wide.
He's bringing
and then you will introduce Chung Ji as the president of the International Light-Cone Advisory Committee. And we would like to say some words of welcome as well. But in fact, we welcome and thank you. And first invite Chung Ji. He will invite me. It's going to be a chain reaction. So all you have to do is introduce Chung Ji as president of OCAC.
Okay.
And then after that, we'll take over.
Okay.
Thank you.
And I
you just sit down after you've introduced Chung Ji and say a few words. So I'll help get everybody's attention for you. Okay. Ready? Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen.
Well, my dear, very, very distinguished friends, I'm very, very honored and privileged to welcome you all here at the conference banquet dinner today. I also welcome you once again to this great country, India, and to this small town of Delhi. And I'm indeed really very happy, and I'm very delighted to have so many distinguished guests here from around the world. I can say actually I can count on fingers. I know each and everybody's name on my fingertips. We have been writing back and forth, talking back and forth with all the people. And I would even like to mention, as far as possible, you can forgive me or remind me for the lapses on my part. let me first start with the far off land that I can think of is Brazil. You can, I would like to, I would try to point you out somewhere.
Closest
Brazil.
Closest
Brazil. Oh, it is here.
Oh.
My great friend, Pacheco de Mello, he comes from Sao Paulo.
Thank you.
Let's give him a big hand. He comes all the way from Sao Paulo to discover India. And I'm very, very grateful to you, Pacheco. I'm very grateful to you.
Thank you very much.
Then, if I go by distances, then I would place maybe US at the second number. With respect to, you have to cross Atlantic Ocean for going to the US. And if I remember correctly, some of the, I think, three co-chairs of this particular Delhi meeting, Light-Cone meeting, are with us today. And all three of them are from US. Professor James Wherry from the Iowa State University. He has been helping me day and night in the various conceptual, organizational aspects of the conference, helping me like my guide all the time. I can see Stan smiling there. He's like the father figure to all of us, actually. I must tell you, he is the central figure. The black hole sitting inside this entire of Light-Cone Physics worldwide. He has very strong gravitational attraction. he can pull anybody inside the radius of his event horizon. And he's actually very, very good at it. When half of the light cone enters this event horizon, it cannot escape this event horizon. It has to go completely inside. That is what I learned from my friend Samir Mathur, who is not here today. But some months ago, he was here in Delhi, and he explained to me that when one half of the light cone enters in the event horizon, for whatever reasons, it cannot escape out. It has to go entirely into the black hole. And so let's give a big hand to. I wish he continues to guide all of us throughout the world for this particular activity of Light-Cone Physics to inspire all the younger people. He is very good at inspiring younger people. He is always able to catch hold of younger guys and he initiates them. I personally remember when I was rather young, 32 years ago, I remember I happened to meet him for the first time in Eugene in 1980. You remember Moravshik was organizing few body conference at Eugene?
Yes.
And so I had a little poster there. I was presenting a poster on the quark diquark model for baryons. I remember, and Stan was so kind. He came to me and he kept talking to me on this, what is this quark diquark model and what I thought. I hardly knew any physics at that time. I still don't know physics. At that time, I was much too young. And Stan was so kind to me that he said, after this, what are you going to do? I said, I have no idea. I have come out of my country for the very first time. He said, no, you please then come to my theory, select theory group after the Eugene conference. And so I was very excited, and my Guruji, Professor N. Mitra, wanted to attract me to Berkeley for some nuclear physics conference, but I told him, no, Stan has invited me. I have some vision in my mind. I said, I'm not even a participant at Berkeley, but I'm now going to be a participant with Stan. So I visited him, and I'm extremely thankful to him. Since then, he has been continuously motivating me. Whenever I write to him day or night, he immediately responds, whether he's sitting on the airport or he's entering a lecture room for giving a seminar. He would write, I'm just now entering a seminar room, and I will get back to you later. So he's a very strong pillar of support, but I think he does this to almost everybody whosoever comes in his contact, and he himself discovers the younger people. So he is amongst us. I'm extremely happy, and I'm very grateful to him. The president of the International Light-Cone Advisory Committee, Professor Chuang Ji from North Carolina State University, is here. He is one of the co-chairs of this meeting, Delhi meeting, and he is very, very much here. Chuang, welcome you so much to Delhi and to this great land of India, and I hope you will continue to guide us. And then we have many, many friends from Europe, but I must not forget Rafael is sitting here. I cannot ignore him. And he talks about ADS, CFT, and integrability, and many, many things. And he offered many choices to me for the talks. And we were happy that we were able to persuade him to come here.
Daya Shankar, should he qualify as an Indian or as an American?
She is both. She is both. For me, in fact, in India, we people believe in a Sanskrit proverb which says, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, which means the entire earth is one family. And I really personally believe so. Whether in US or in India, I mean, it's just a question of, as I often say, you need to locate your coordinates somewhere on this globe. And from there you can operate. But all of us, we keep moving around all the time, traveling all around all the time. So we really justify this ancient Indian proverb of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. All of us meet several times, so often at many places, and we travel around, but you need to draw salary from one place. and she prefers to draw a fat salary as compared to the Indian salary. So she is in a very beautiful land of Iowa. I visit James very often, and it's a really very, very beautiful.
You should come to us too.
sure, we would.
Ours is actually nicer than theirs.
Let's give a big hand to Usaji. I know it's a land of trees and farms and corn, sweet corn. Am I right?
Yes.
Sweet corn.
But
so
it's really beautiful.
It's really beautiful. Yes, I can easily get lost into their fields and the greens and so on. So Usaji has been very wise to choose that place as a working place.
Bad winters.
And Rafael comes from Miami University, yes, and is very kind. I think you are coming here for the first time.
First time.
first time, and I hope it's not going to be the last time. So we look forward to your visits to us again and again and again. And before I forget, our friend Fernando Quevedo is also here. It's a very pleasant news for all of us. Only in the last few days, we discovered that he was going to be in Delhi during just this time of the conference. And so we are very grateful to you, Quevedo. Fernando, we are very, very grateful to you. And he would be giving his talk tomorrow. So we are very, because we didn't really had enough time to beforehand invite you and so on, but we are just lucky. It's a matter of luck for us that you are here. And we are very happy to welcome you here in at this meeting in Delhi. And then I have some German friends here from Bremen, Betty Hartmann, Jutta Kunz, my very, very dear friend. Yes, and Gerhard Drolshagen. He qualifies here in two different ways. he is a physicist by himself. He works in Netherlands. Am I right?
Correct, yes.
Correct. Very close to, so they live in Oldenburg. It's just at the boundaries almost. So he can cross every day to Netherlands, and it's a very tiny toy model of the conference. When I was there in Oldenburg, he was participating in a conference where there were how many people? If you wanted,
about
3,000. About 3,000 participants were there in that meeting. I remember. I think this many number you had at your home for dinner. if I'm approximately correct.
No, only those who qualified to visit us.
So I was lucky. I made it.
It was
just
about 20 out of the 3,000.
20 out of 3,000.
Yes. You qualified.
And it's just the double of that. So it's approximately the same. And he also is the husband of my dear friend Jutta Kunz. So he has double qualifications to be here. And Betty Hartmann also has double qualifications. Let me tell you. She did have with Jutta Kunz. She is a professor at Bremen. So she also has double qualifications. And who else? Helly, I am very grateful to Helly. She is sitting there. She is originally from England. And I just dragged her here. She wasn't in a very. She always wanted to come and so on. Then she was with her grandmother for some time, and she wasn't sure if she comes. I said, you please at least come for a week. And we are very grateful to you, Helly, that you eventually decided to come. We are very happy to welcome Judith Brodsky, Hildegard. These are my very, very, very close dear friends who meet me very often. And I feel very rich with their love and affection for me. Let me have a look. I don't want
Professor
Sergio. Oh, Monsieur Sergio. Monsieur Sergio and Madame Sergio, Madeleine Sergio and Hagop Sergio, my very dear friends from Orsay. When I go to Orsay, I feel it's my second home. Is that correct? In the fall, I have been there in all seasons at different occasions of the years at many, many points. He's a very soft-spoken person and very dear friend of mine. We are very grateful to both of you to be here, and we welcome you all. And we have two guests from Japan, Yuji Sato and Yuichi Hoshino. This is Yuji Sato and Yuichi Hoshino, both from Japan. My friend Hoshino Yuji, he was always worried about the warm weather. He wasn't sure, even if he was finding December to be, maybe he was worried. He told me he lives under the temperatures below 20 degrees all the time. So I couldn't think of better times than this, because here now it's the time of, when I hope you find comfortable, sir. It's not too warm for you. He was very worried that would it be warm or something. I said, well, we somehow survive all the time, so we will make you survive and we will make sure that you return back home very safely. So we are very grateful to UJ and UC, both of you, and we really welcome you both here. We are very, we feel very rich with your presence. Here I see my friend Lubo from Bratislava. He is my traveler friend. I like to travel around with him. Anywhere, you can go with him anywhere and you can't get lost. Yes,
we used to walk a lot.
We used to walk a lot together. So once you are with him, you can't get lost. He will always take you, bring you back home. So he's my very inspiring friend, and Professor Karmano and Mrs. Karmano. Marina, yes, Marina. I must not do that mistake again. Marina and Vladimir Karmano. They are my senior colleagues, very respected colleagues, and I mean they really have been very eager, and I mean they have not turned any corners unturned to come here. We are very, very grateful to you, sir. And we really welcome you with the whole heart. And so we are really very happy. I'm working under the, my remote control is with James Wary. So I have given you the powers to correct me. Oh, yes, 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 Lake Adhikari. Should I call you Lake or Lekha? Lake Adhikari.
Lekha is already having long history, so Lake is okay.
Lake is okay, very good. So, Lake, welcome you very much. And
thank
I
you.
Know you are very soon going to be given the very McCarthy Award also.
Thank you.
And I leave it for a few more minutes when people congratulate you for that.
Okay.
So, but I can tell you one confusion. For a long time, I had the confusion that this was Lekha Adhikari by some girl. And my friend Supriya told me that the name sounds a Bengali name. But when you came and registered, then my students told me, sir, you were wrong. She's not a girl, she is a boy. So, Lake, we are very, very grateful to you. And I wish you had come along with Matthias Burkhardt, that we miss very much. Please do convey our concerns to us that we missed him a lot at Delhi conference. He is one of the very active guys who is all the time drinking, eating physics. He does nothing else except to drink and eat and breathe physics. Nothing else. Matthias Burkhardt is a, in his absence, I like to say one or two lines. He finally couldn't make it to come here. He is originally from Germany, and I once told you that these Burkhardts, Yuta also had one co-worker by the name Kleihaus Burkhardt, and they all are similar. I said all Burkhardts are similar. They ride on the bike. They are very thin and lean and tall always. but they are always very slim guys. They eat very little and they work very hard. Most sincere guys on earth. Most sincere guys on earth. So you please tell him that you missed him at Delhi meeting here. And then I could easily switch over to India. So when I look on this side, Professor Harish Chandra Chandola, could you please just so that people would recognize him? And I think it's one of the most beautiful places in India. All those who have not been there, for me,
definitely.
I go there so often, it's like my home.
Sure.
And it's one of the most beautiful places in India. And like you say, Heidelberg is the most beautiful place in Germany. Nainital is one of the most beautiful towns in India. So, and all of you could write to him, he would be very kind to invite. And another colleague, Dr. Suchi Vora, she is at the same university. And this is Dr. Suchi Bist. I always make this mistake. Our husband writes Vora, so I make this mistake again please forgive me for that. And these two young girls from, one is doing PhD with Professor Chandola Garima, and this, you have already heard the talk of Jay. I don't need to, she doesn't need any introduction anymore. You have impressed everybody with your talk, I must tell you. People told me in your absence, she gave a wonderful talk. And I told James was sitting with me, I said, please do a good job. So that's very good. Here I have Nimai from Guwahati University. We both and Subrata Chakraborty, both of us, all three of us. And we used to sit together in my the office, which I now have. I still call it from the Mitra's office, my Guruji's place. I'm just fortunate and lucky to have been with him. And today he could not come because he was not feeling very strong. So for that reason, he said, let me, if you allow me. So I mean, he was supposed to be here, but he couldn't make it. So we used to sit in the same room with Professor Mitra's room and work together until 10 in the evening every day. And our friend, Gyan Maharana, Gyan is knowledge, and he is the god of knowledge, as I call it, Gyan ke Devta, god of knowledge. This is Gyan Maharana. He is very kind. He just landed back from Geneva, and he made it to our conference because he had promised us. So actually, I'm really so grateful to everybody. Everybody, you see, these days, everybody is busy, and people still try to somehow, if they really want to go, they find time. Professor Amitabh Rai Chaudhary, my in the country, one of the very, very leading physicists. I mean, both Partho and Amitabh Rai Chaudhary. Let me tell you what Partha means. Partha, his full name is Partha Sarthi. Where is my other friend Partha?
He hasn't come.
He hasn't come?
I didn't see him.
Why hasn't he come? my organizers, why did you leave Partha Mitra back home at the guest house? How did you do that mistake? Yeah? Okay. So it's not. Okay. But even in his absence, I would like to thank him. He has been so kind. He has come with, he has been very generous. People are busy, but he decided to spend his week with us. The entire week he is available to us. We are very fortunate and very grateful to him. He is, not only has he come alone, he has come with his wife, and also his son has also joined. And tomorrow we will have his talk probably. So I'm really grateful to him. I mean, people coming so wholeheartedly, my friend. This Partha, let me first tell you what is Partha. Partha is half name, actually full name is Partha Sarthi. There was a great epic war in India called as Mahabharata war, which was fought something like 5,125 years ago, probably.
But not too far from here, right?
Hmm?
Not too far from
not here. Too far from here, yes. One of the kingdoms used to be in Delhi called Indraprastha. We still have Indraprastha, which used to be the capital of the Pandavas, of the two bearing factions. One was Pandavas and the other were Kauravas. And there was the central character, Arjuna, who was supposed to be a great warrior, who is credited with winning the entire Mahabharata war along with his brothers. And Sarathi is the person who was driving his chariot, the driver of his chariot. This was supposed to be Lord Krishna. So Partha Sarathi, actually, if you listen half the name, Krishna always, they were friends actually, and they were brothers also. So he always used to call him Partha this, Partha that, Partha do this, you shouldn't do that, and so on. And he has, I mean, all this entire Bhagavad Gita, which is so famous in India, he really, the Krishna narrated it to Arjuna before the beginning of the war. He gave some sermons to this, his friend, Arjuna, best friend. I'm so lucky that I have many sarathis to run me around. my two sarathis, before I forget, this Supriya Kar. And where is Vinod? Vinod, where is Vinod? Where is Vinod? Vinod, not yet. These two are my really charioteers of my drivers. They have been really driving around this life. I'm only a symbolic person. They are too kind to have given me this freedom. But they have already, I tell you the secret, a couple of days ago, both of them told me, you can switch off your mind and you don't worry about anything, you just keep sitting. Don't worry about things.
So it's so, your unofficial hub.
Okay, so my friend James asked me to take rest for some time. You see how lucky I am. I have so many chariots, so many sarathis between you to guide me around. So Hildegard, please could you join for a minute?
Yes.
And this is James Berry, and she has allowed me to call her all the time, Hildegard. Then Yuta has also given me that permission to call her only Yuta and not Professor Kunj or Professor Yuta. She says, you just simply call me Yuta. It's very unusual for Germany. They always call you Herr or Professor or Doctor, but...
Herr Professor.
She is also German, yes, I must tell you. Hildegard is from Marburg, am I right?
Yeah.
She is from Marburg, and I'm very fortunate and lucky that these people, they support me all the time. Would you like to say a few words to the people before we move on?
Well, let me suggest that be a little bit later.
A little bit later?
First come to the other table.
Yes. I come to the other table. You see, my mind has stopped. I have already switched off my mind. Yes. I had come only up to my main charioteers, but I have too many charioteers. You see, we used to have the chariots which were run by many horses. And you could have more sarathis there. So these are my young team. Devbrat, Dheeraj, he is still a master's student but is very active. Devbrat is doing his PhD with Supriyakar. This Sanjeev Kumar is doing his PhD with myself and Usha. This is Sunita Singh. She is working for her PhD also with Supriyakar. This is Hema. Sorry, Hira. Hira means diamond. So here is a diamond, Indian diamond. This is Hira, my colleague. And yes, of course, I can't forget him. I just simply, he's my soulmate. So when I can call him even at midnight, when I like to share any of my views or thoughts, I can check, Vinod, are you awake? Can we talk? And he always comes forward with some suggestions to me, so of whatever, not necessarily physics, anything I talk and discuss with him. He's so he's a very, very dear friend of mine, and he keeps guiding me all the time, like he's doing right now. Yes, I swear. You see, my friends are so generous, they cannot allow me to make mistakes. This is a very, very dear friend of mine. A very, very dear friend of mine. Let me tell you, he is my teacher who taught me particle physics when I just joined my PhD degree after my master's at Delhi University. He was my senior, and he used to make me sit in the library or sometimes in the garden, and he would explain me. So you see, he always, even now, he always calls me to aisa kar, aisa mat kar. And I love it so much. He's like my elder brother. Like in German, you always talk, du musst das machen, du musst das nicht machen. So, und nicht G können trinken or G können. He always tells me, do, which I really love. And so I have grown up under his love. He's like my elder brother, and all the time he's my senior. And more important than all this is he has always loved. So this
I would like to say something about him. Actually, he has a background in electronics.
At my master's level.
Master's in electronics. So he came from outside Delhi. So they generally find a difficulty adjusting to the city Delhi, you know, because a small time guy coming to a big city, there is always a problem. So I found he was struggling with his things. Then suddenly I was doing S matrix. He was asking, what is this? I said, this is so beautiful, bra, cat, notation. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to understand anything. Those who invented, even they don't know. Even they don't know. What is I, even they don't know. You just pick up and you will enjoy it. So I put him on the horizon of this, and now he has been sucked into it.
No, I remember, book by Muirhead. Yeah. Elementary particle physics,
a very beautiful book
and this Marsec,
electromagnetic interaction.
Marsec and who is the other guy?
Sudarshan.
Marsec and Sudarshan, very famous book. It had just come out at that time, new. So he used to tell me the vector bosons. I learned from him at that point of time. I had not heard of them until my master's degree. So he gradually introduced me to particle physics. I am very grateful.
And I am so happy to see that you are doing so wonderful, and you have traveled so abroad. I wish you more good luck.
This is my friend Alok Mishra. He is nearby to Delhi. It's almost a twin city of Delhi. He is at Roorkee, and in fact, he is one of the great organizers of these meetings, conferences. After every couple of years, he organizes some conference at Roorkee. I used to go there when it was a university. He invited me a couple of times there, even for giving a popular talk and for the some conference which he organized. And he's a real, you have already heard his talk. He is very deeply involved in spaghetti springs. So he discovered some neutralinos and gravitinos, and I'm sure he would tell you what are the best candidates for the dark matter. And with his algebraic calculations, he can tell what is going to be the gravitino like. Yes, I'm very grateful to you for having come here. He was busy with some examination work and duties at the institute, which is also primary, but he was able to find 2 days' time. I'm very, very grateful to you and welcome you so much. Here is another gentleman, Prashant Tripathi. Actually, I have personally met him for the first time. I was hearing his talk, and for some reasons, I had to go out from my table when he started his talk. And few minutes later, when I came, he happens to be a very close friend of my friend Supriya. So you see, he is doubly related to me. He is a friend of my friend, so he is even more important. And I didn't know this was Prashant Tripathi speaking. I told Supriya, this boy seems to be very bright. He said, yeah, he is indeed bright. So we are very happy to have you here, and we welcome you here, and I look forward that you visit us again and again.
You're almost done.
Usha.
This is my
Usha.
Okay. This is Deepankar Chaturvedi and Asmita Mukherjee. Yes. I'm calling her Asmita because my American friends call her Asmita. Otherwise, I would have called her Asmita Mukherjee. She is at Mumbai, and she is actually also busy. So we carefully tried to work out the schedule of our conference. So Asmita Mukherjee, Anuradha Mishra, and Jay More, these three people, two of these, Asmita has to somehow leave tomorrow morning, and Anuradha also. So where is Anuradha sitting next to you?
No, she left.
She left?
Yeah.
She's not here. She had left for Bombay?
No, she has left for her home.
Oh, now I recollect her mother who lives here in Noida?
Mother.
Yes, her mother lives here in Noida. So she tried to take this evening off to be with her mother. And so we accept it. Jay, please do convey our welcome and regards to her on our behalf of everybody who is here. And we welcome you very much. And Asmita and Anuradha and these people, they have a nice group in Bombay. Although they have different institutes, she is at IIT and Anuradha is at Mumbai University. But they are really, really, they work very closely. So I'm very happy. And this is another friend of ours who has been collaborating with James and everybody on Light-Cone, Deepankar Chakravarti, younger friend from IIT Kanpur. And I think you give your talk tomorrow?
Yeah,
tomorrow. So I have always heard his name, but I happen to meet him now, and I hope we will keep meeting. And maybe we might even work together at some point of time whenever the opportunity arises. Let me not miss this. In the formal introduction, this is Dr. Usha Kulshreshtha, She is at the Kirodimal College of Delhi University. Maybe is it your alma mater, Kirodimal? Are you related?
No, I'm not from Kirodimal, but no? I know where Kirodimal is.
We go for our lunch or coffee near Kirodimal.
Yes.
That's right, that's right. There used to be an Indian coffee house there. So on this Bangalore Road, it happens to be a very fashionable street for, I don't know, I can tell the secrets, some of the secrets, that Bangalore Road is supposed to be a very fashionable street. So Kamla, Kirodimal College is located there, and with our visitors, sometimes we happen to go there to have Chinese food or spaghettis or I don't know, many glass noodles. Or. But apart from that, there are some good international standard coffee houses there, so we sometimes go to have a cappuccino there. I think if Fernando would have time, we would love to take you to that place where you can have your favorite cappuccino. So, I can show, I can see this young boy standing there, and this person, where are you? This Jay has been very nice friend of ours, a nice philosopher, and has been very, very helpful to us. Oh, Sunendu, I have to go to Sunendu. You keep sitting. One of the brightest, youngest faculty member of Delhi University, Sunendu Sarkar. And I'm so lucky, and I feel really rich in his absence. I tell people that he has enriched our department by joining us as a permanent faculty member. He is, by training, a string theorist. And he is a very, very simple person. My friend Partha Mitra is not around. I would have, even in his absence, I can say that Partha Mitra and Sunendu Sarkar, they have similarities. Both of them are the simplest guys you can think of. So they hardly speak, but they keep doing physics all the time. They are very sincere people, very, very bright young men. This is Brajendra Daya. He is doing his PhD with Vinod Nautiyal, my friend. This active man, young man, he can take any daring responsibilities of taking you to Taj Mahal or to take you to Qutub Minar or Red Fort or whatever. Delhi, he is a very daring, very trustworthy person. If I call him, Brajendra, please do this or that, and he is too happy all the time he is there. Another person, Pankaj, is not here. I miss him. Please tell him that I miss him. Another young man who is not here at the moment. Somebody correct me?
I haven't
spoken about you. Let me do it again. I suggest that all of you please give a big hand to my friends. Okay, once again. My all activity would be incomplete without him. He is the.
You've done it.
Yes.
Chuang Ji,
yes. I think I eventually go back to my friend Chuang, and I invite you, Chuang. He is the president of the ILCAC International Light-Cone Advisory Committee, and I invite Chuang, please take over the charge and help me. I can take your seat here.
Thank you. Well, I guess many of you do not know about the International Light-Cone Advisory Committee. We had been now slightly over 20 years, and there are two board of directors accompanying me, Stan Broski and James Berry. So I think they will proceed with some MacArthur Award we have been giving, and this year we are giving 12th award, and the recipient is with us. But before I go to my seat, I would like to really thank all the organizers to make this wonderful LightCone meeting. So on behalf of International LightCone Advisory Committee, I would like to thank Professor Daya Kulshreshtha and all the organizing members. James will present. He's actually a so-called chair of the development committee, so he will give out the MacArthur Award, and I think Stan will say a few words also.
Yeah. So,
Thank you very much.
We'll make this very brief. We're very fortunate to have sponsors who have donated money to the International Light-Cone Advisory Committee to support the Gary McCarter Travel Fund. Gary McCarter was a senior distinguished member of our community. And I would like to ask Stan if he would say a few words about Gary McCarter before we make the award, so you have a historical perspective.
Yeah. Well, I'd like to add, first of all, thanks to Daya and all the colleagues here. This meeting's been very impressive. You hear all these brilliant talks, and it's expanding the whole province of light-cone physics, so it's great. Gary McCarter would have loved to have been here, and unfortunately he passed away. He was a preeminent light-front person. He developed many things in Schwinger model, all sorts of 1+1 theories and so on, extensively promoted the light-front work. And his wife, Sheila, has carried on, in fact, in this place, and supported young people in this province. So he's a great physicist, and we're very fortunate to have people like that. The meeting in Dallas was really in his honor, in fact, that we had about 2 years ago. So I hope all of you continue in the light-cone work and so on. You'll hear more about it. In fact, it's really one of the most important ways to solve non-perturbative theories. And you can even apply to string theory and to even black hole people. We'll have to think about that. Anyway, thank you very much, Daya, for all of you. Thank you.
So it is the Gary McCarter's wife, Sheila McCarter, who unfortunately could not be here at this meeting, but has been able to attend some of our light-cone meetings. Through her support and friends of Gary McCarter, we have a fund which we are using to make awards on a competitive basis to young scientists to attend these meetings. And we are very fortunate tonight to have three previous award winners with us, and I'd like to recognize each of the previous award winners who are carrying on stellar careers, contributing to our field, and also giving invited talks at this meeting. First, I would like to mention Usha Kulshreshtha, who has declined to give an invited talk. Thank you, Usha. And next, I would like to recognize...
Asmita.
Where did she go?
She has gone somewhere.
She'll be back. In the meantime, I'd like to award this year's award for this particular meeting. This is a young student in his fifth year of PhD studies, working with already mentioned Professor Matthias Burkhardt at New Mexico State University. And we will hear his